This video is not sponsored or affiliated with the brand Sakura. Whatever I'll be speaking in this video is purely based on my opinions and point of views regarding the product. Thank you so much and I hope you'll enjoy this video and will find it helpful. Hey guys, in today's video we'll be reviewing Sakura brand's Jelly Roll Collection Soufflé Pens. Well, I had been dreamed of having one for myself for a very long time, maybe infinite number of days, I don't know. I have been requesting my daddy for buying this pen for myself, and finally it's here. This video is gonna be a complete review of this product, so please make sure you watch this video till the very end and hope it's helpful for you guys too. So let's get started. Like a Hellcat. So while talking about the packaging, it looks actually good. It has a plastic packaging and it also says that it stands out on the dark surfaces, so we are gonna try this out soon. And there are also some instructions and some general stuff about this pen written at the backside, so we'll catch up with that later. And while opening it, it has a hinge sort of thing, so after usage you can place your pens in it and close it. So I'm quite happy with how the packaging is. So talking about the brand, it's from Sakura. It is a Japanese company and it's from the collection of Jelly Roll pens. Its name is Soufflé. It also has various other there are many more varieties of Jelly Roll pens which I'll show you later on. And its price is 600 rupees, which is quite expensive, I know. But maybe that's because of exportations to India and so on, because it's made in Japan. Well, it has 10 shades, which is orange, purple, black, cyan, yellow, peach, light green, and white, blue, and baby pink. And talking about its technical qualities, here are as follows. Number 1. It's suitable on not only paper but also on hard surfaces such as mirror, mobile phones, frame, etc. Number 2. Unique 3D matte color effect. Number 3, its drying time can vary on different types of surfaces. For example, on paper it can take 2 to 5 minutes. Number 4, there will be no smears, feathers or bleed through on most of the papers. Number 5, the nib of each pen is of 0.6 mm thickness. And at last, number 6, its availability is of 10 shades. So let's see its general uses. So its general uses are as follows. Number 1. Titles, lettering and line borders. Number 2. Doodles, drawings and greeting cards. And number 3. Holiday ornaments or votives. So talking about the pen by looks, it looks pretty cute, aesthetic, simple and minimalistic. I like the look of these pens, but my mom didn't like it, I don't know why. And as we talked about it before, it has 10 shades and I'm expected actually a few more colors, but I think it should be fine. Now I'm removing the plastic sort of thing from the nibs and it will be ready to use. So after taking that plastic from the tip of the pen, these pens are ready to use. So for checking these pens out, I have a cardstock of black chart paper in which I have stuck white paper as well. So we'll check out if these pens actually work on dark surface too, and we'll do a versus kind of thing if it looks better in black or white. And the package also mentions that for best results you have to wait for its drying time. So we'll wait for it too. So let's see. And here in this time-lapse video, I'm trying the colors on both black and white. And we'll check it after 10 to 15 minutes. The drying time on paper in the package is mentioned for 2 to 3, but I'll still take time. I just want to check if it comes properly or not, so I'll give it a 10 or 15 minutes time for this. So I'm done swatching the colors on the cardstock on both black and white. Now we'll check the results after 10 or 15 minutes, and after seeing the end results, I'll comment my opinion on these pens. So please make sure you watch this video till the very end for this. So coming back after 10 to 15 minutes, I get to see the results. That the color on black has come way much better than white, and anyways it's not even made for white though, so I guess that white loses this match and black wins. So as the brand promises, this color actually stands out on black surface, I mean the black color. And it also said that it will add some dimension when written. So we'll check this out too. So after checking, I get to understand that it doesn't have a 3D imprint effect on the paper. So maybe the brand which promises this thing is wrong. But also I feel that maybe I'm wrong at this point, because I was in a hurry. And it said like you need patience for this if you want that 3D imprint, because when I did that orange thing, it has a little dimension, but still I don't think so there's a need of 3D imprint or so. I'm having mixed feelings about this, if it actually works in terms of 3D thing. Also I'm not satisfied with the peach and black color, because it doesn't have that good results on the dark surface in comparison to white. So I'm not quite satisfied with these two colors. Overall, the Sakura's Jelly Rolls Souffle collection is perfectly fine. If you guys have 600 rupees budget, then you can give it a shot and buy this and try it out for yourself. So if you say the ratings, I would like to give it a 4 out of 5. So you guys can give it a shot and do try it out, and let me know your point of view in the comment sections. While editing, I got to know that the color on dark surface was not visible. So here is the image, a clear image of it. So you can refer this image for the exact result. Now let's see a quick recap of what we saw regarding this product. Number 1. The packaging is great. Number 2, it's a little bit expensive, but it's still worth a buy. Number 3, it's from brand Sakura, which is made in Japan product. Number 4, its availability is of 10 pastel shades. Number 5, it can be used in various types of surfaces, for example mirror, glass, paper, etc. Number 6, the nib size is of 0.6 mm. Number 7. Drying time can vary from different surfaces, so please be patient. Number 8. The surface on which ink is should not be touched, or else it will result in smudging. Number 9. Don't touch the ink unless the drying time is over. Number 10. No smears bleed through on most papers. Please take care of the following points for the best results. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please make sure to give us a big thumbs up, share this video with your family, friends and loved ones, and subscribe to my channel and click that bell icon to always get notified whenever I upload a new video. And I also hope that this review video was helpful to you guys. If yes, then please let me know that in the comment section down below. And also do let me know if I should make more such review videos of any other kind of stuff other than stationery too in the comments. I'd be very glad. to know your opinions too. And before leaving this video, please subscribe to my channel. It will help me out a ton and I'll be super motivated to post more such videos in the future. So until then, peace, signing out, bye, and I hope you have a very great day ahead. Hey, thanks for watching this video till the very end. I hope the video which is suggested here in the outro will also be liked by you. So please make sure you check this video out. Have a great day.